morning, everyone. I am just getting back from the gym right now, and I just wanted to clear my mind and give myself a little bit of time to think last night. I know there's been so many messages and so many people, so many hateful messages as well, which is really the whole reason why I'm doing this. A lot of people talking, a lot of blogs, a lot of posts, a lot of people, like, you know, getting misconstrued. The screenshots that you've seen me post are very recent from my iPhone. The infamous Android that you see here now is now plugged in. So the screenshots that you've seen were not from my Android. Just to add clarification, those are not my Android screenshots. Those are my iPhone screenshots. My Android is on the charger right now and is charging. You know, the whole reason why I've been doing this is so we can stop the bullying. And
sure, Jan.
Adding clarification with this, you guys. I don't need any new clientele. I don't need people to buy my wigs.
Bitch! The doll!
I don't need a new job. I'm very well secure in my career. The reason why I'm doing this... So I knew what I was doing when I opened up the Pandora's box and when I spoke about what I was going to speak about. Did I lose some friends that I thought were my friends? Yeah, for sure. Did I, you know, affect a big community? Absolutely, I did. But I think that this is going to affect a community. I knew that I was going to get backlash and I was going to get a lot of hate mail. I knew that there was going to be people constantly telling me to go kill myself, to go do this. I've seen this happen to so many people because I've been around for so many years. So the big picture of this is what I'm been around for a long time. Like, I've been around since Cat's been around, yo. And like, if something keeps on falling off the shelf and breaking, I tend to think that it may not be the products on the shelf, and it may just be the shelf that needs some fixing. So, you know, with all this said and done, guys, I'm not gonna go on with endless rants today. I want to continue with a bunch of rants today. It is Friday. I want you guys to have an amazing, beautiful day. I have some wigs that I have to color for some amazing clients. It's the weekend. Enjoy yourself. Get off the computer. Get off the internet and go and climb a tree. Go smell the air. Till then, I will be sitting here enjoying my warm cup of tea. Earl Grey with a little bit of creamer. Tried posting a video right now of a really intense text message that I wanted to share with you guys, and I am going to try to reshare this with you properly because the way I posted it right now, it did not come out pretty clear. So it was a bit scrambled. It didn't make sense. So taking it back to August 1st, 2017, I asked this individual if they were upset with me, and they said allegedly no, we just talked yesterday. You know, at that time I said, well, I just noticed you unfollow me on social media. I know it's really nothing but response being, I know it's just Instagram, you know, and this is their response basically saying that this is how they felt about me working with certain artists that they did not approve of. Over that I was not really allowed to work with, and it goes into making it seem like it's okay. Here's my response. They go into my response basically stating about how I
no, baby, no. You don't want just a platform to showcase these people. You said you want a platform. Why are you so thirsty?
I feel bad, you know, and basically the same thing that I'm trying to preach now, dude. I just wanted to showcase my talent on different people, black, white, Asian, Chinese, doesn't matter. Hair was always hair for me. It always has been, always will be. But this message is saying is something I'm really not proud of. I'm really disgusted and I'm embarrassed that I allowed myself to subject myself to such stupidity, to have a dollar and make a living, and to be in fear, live in fear, dude. This is the shit that I put up. Basically, here's the disgusting part. It comes back to, you know, September 5th, 2017. I'm basically talking about a title of a channel. They're agreeing, keeping it 100. I'm basically also talking about unfollowing a person that I used to hang out with at that time. They basically agree for me to unfollow that person. They agree that it's cool that I unfollow that person. And also, if I'm done posting that gorilla, that they would love to follow me again, their friend, right? Try telling me. This is my response, my disgusting response. Disgusting.
There's so much drama going on right now.
Ooh, girl, she's already the hair hurt.
Can we just have one peaceful day in the beauty drama community? Would that be too much to ask for? Hey, what is up all my social climbing friends? It's Dustin and I am back with another video. Oh my god. These intros are getting longer and longer and longer, but I apologize. I have to give you that for context. I do hope that you enjoyed that AHS inspired intro with Jeffree Star. I seen that and I really wanted to like put my own spin on it because you guys know I love American Horror Story so much. It was actually, fun fact, one of the very, well actually the very first video that I uploaded on my YouTube channel. I was talking about Roanoke and how I thought that it was a crazy, crazy season. So you guys, as you guys know, David Scissorhands, David Anything For View Scissorhands has uploaded, well not uploaded, he put on his Instagram story again about Jeffree Star and he showed these text messages. I hope that you were able to see them. I did zoom in on them and pause for you guys to be able to read those. And basically, this is my thing with him. You guys know everything that has happened with Jackie Aina and Laura Lee, Jackie Aina and Jeffree Star. Jackie Aina has been pulled into this indirectly by this David guy, and he's wanting to now speak out because of the way that Jeffree Star treated Jackie Aina. Now you guys know from his Instagram post, he does work with a lot of different influencers. He works with Nikita. We've seen him do Manny. I'm pretty sure he's probably done Jacqueline. Not 100% sure on that. He's done Laura. And one of the things before we get into the whole Jackie Aina thing that stuck out to me is that this guy was like completely okay if Jeffree Star did, in fact, say this. I have my own theories on what this guy's doing. We'll get into that in a little bit as well. But if you stopped and you read what this message said, he's like, I'm about to go slay Laura's hair. I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. So to me, that was almost some kind of like form of repentance for this guy. He did not want to like offend Jeffree that he was doing Laura's hair, because we all know at this point in time that Laura and Jeffree were not friends. They were not speaking and they were not actually communicating with one another. That's still like the current thing today. They are not friends, and Jeffree Star has made that like abundantly clear to all of us that he is no longer friends with any of these people, Manny, Laura, Nikita, which was really interesting because I was sent like at least 15 DMs, and I'm not even exaggerating, of this screenshot where Jeffree Star liked Nikita Dragon's tweet, and I'm just sitting here like, I do not know what to make of this as like a drama commentator. I don't know which way the cards are gonna fall. I don't know what is gonna happen next. You never even know. But let's get into this whole thing about Jackie Aina. Now, I do want to say that I do enjoy watching Jackie Aina. I do think she's funny. However, I am not dismissing the fact of what she did to Petty Page. I think that if you are going to accuse someone of something and you are going to say it to a massive amount of people and you're going to allege that they did something illegal to you and stole money from you, you should have went to the authorities. If you felt like you had that much backing to what you were saying, if you felt like what you were saying was 100% true and you had all of this proof, why didn't you just go to the authorities? So for that reason, right there in particular, there has been no charges brought up against Petty Page. I do not believe what Jackie is alleging about her, and I think that that was fucked up on so many different levels for her to do that to her. So aside from that, I do like Jackie. I do like her personality. She is funny. She makes me laugh a whole lot. But if you would have seen in the intro, allegedly from these text messages, this guy is saying that Jeffree Star called her a gorilla. Now first and foremost, if by chance these things are real and were proven like with 100% validity any time in the future, I just want to go on record and say that that is absolutely vile and disgusting talk that you would use any way, shape, or form to say that a person of color, a black woman, looks like a gorilla. That is completely deplorable. And if this ever comes out that this is like valid and this is true, I will be very, very pissed off. So he goes in this text message and he shows everything, and he says that he wants to showcase his talent with different hair types and he wants a platform. Now, in my intro, you've seen that I paused and I put in my little me emoji. It's so interesting that this guy wants to speak out now. If he was gonna speak out, he had all the time in the world to speak out about this. If this was in fact true, it would have gave more validity for me as somebody that would have been watching this and commenting on this situation if he would have came out right then and been like, hey, ring the alarm, this right here is not right, this right here is not right. But he was sitting there and he was like completely fine with it. As long as he was getting that check,
As long as Jeffree Star was paying his bills, as long as he was on his payroll, he didn't give a shit what Jeffree was saying. So all morals aside, you were valuing this dollar. And now it seems to me like if this is not, like, if this is true, it's fucked up. Like, it's fucked up on so many different levels. But for you to now come out of the woodworks on this, for you to just now speak on this after everything is settled down, it is so suspect to me. Why would you wait on something so big to then just be like, oh, well, girl, I'm on it. I'm tired of hiding, da-da-da-da-da. It seems to me from what I took from that text message, it wasn't about you working with anybody else. It wasn't about you, like, wanting to perfect your craft and show your artistry. It was, you want a platform, boo. You want these people to come on here and subscribe to you. That's why you keep gassing up this video, and that is why you keep putting all this different stuff out. Like, I don't even know what I could do to possibly believe what this guy is saying is true at this point in time, because you guys know, like I said in my last video, there are so many different ways to fake stuff. There are so many different apps. It don't even take an app. You could text yourself. And I feel like this guy was sitting on this. Like, it took him so long to come out with this. Like, who knows how long it could have. And I'm not saying that the receipts are fake. I have my doubts about it. I don't know why, but something just screams to me that this may be fake. And for him to wait so long as he did, it just seems like a total opportunist type of thing for this guy to do. From everything that we've seen with this guy, I'm just ready for him to upload this video. I feel like it's coming to a point where it's like, if you're gonna allege something against anybody, not just Jeffree Star, if you are gonna allege something, a text message is just not gonna be suffice, because literally, like, there are so many different applications just on the computer where you can fake stuff. Like, I feel like now everything has to be hearsay. As far as, like, people saying certain words and people doing certain things, when it comes to, like, really, really defamatory things, We're gonna have to request proof. And I feel like if all of this stuff is true about Jeffree Star, I feel like if it is true, there is going to be a point in time when there's gonna be a video put out about him. And what I mean by that is they're gonna be somebody with, like, a flip cam, a camera phone. They're gonna take a video of him saying this. It hasn't happened yet. So, I mean, I just have to believe, honestly, that this may not have happened, and that is not me taking a side. Like I said, if Jeffree Star did this, he's a disgusting piece of shit. There's no way you could dress up a turd, okay? But I just need more, and I feel like the person that it's coming from and the way that he's presenting this is incredibly thirsty. Incredibly thirsty. Like, what would you do for 200 subscribers, boo? 200 subscribers? You have like 80,000 followers on Instagram, but you worried about 200 subscribers on YouTube? That makes no sense to me. Are you selling your soul for 200 subscribers? The amount of hate that you're getting is equal to the amount of people that Jeffree Star has following him. And there's not a lot of people that actually know about this. Well, they didn't at first, but every single drama channel has covered this. Like, I've had my beef with another drama channel right now, and they have, like, way, way more subscribers than me. You know, when you come out of the woodwork about some shit, you're gonna get hate. So I don't want to hear somebody crying or saying, oh, well, leave me alone, I'm being bullied because of something that they said. I don't know what to say anymore. But you guys, I really want to know your thoughts on this. Do you think that these text messages are real? Because there's just something in my gut that is telling me that they're not, and that this guy is just trying to take a situation and run with it. And I feel like there may be an outside force, someone like Nikita Dragon, behind it. As always, you guys know that I encourage debate. Please be kind to one another in the comments down below. Let me know what you think about all this stuff. Do you think this guy's a fake? Do you think they're real? Do you think they're not real? I don't know. All of this is completely my opinion, allegedly. I just don't even know what to say anymore. But I hope you guys have a great Saturday, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.